Good evening and welcome. We want to start by thanking LungA for making this happen, for hosting us, and for just making this festival happen every year. It nourishes my spirit to come here every year, and would be a dream to live in the atmosphere that thrives here in this community for this week every year.
It's a privilege.
It's a privilege, and we are grateful and honored to be here. So start by giving yourselves a round of applause.
Who we are?
Yes, you're probably asking, who are those guys? If you don't know us, but my name is Jóhann. This is my dear friend and colleague, Haukur Valdimar.
I'm Haukur Valdimar.
And we are 23 and 33 years old, born 10 years apart in the same month. We are students, we are artists, we are athletes, we are consumers. We are so many things.
We are kind of related.
Yes, we are half cousins.
Half cousins.
Yes.
But it's not really special in Iceland because we are kind of all related.
Yes. It's kind of an inside joke for us Icelanders that everybody is related. But that's another thing. You can grab a seat. There are loads of seats.
And the other part.
Haukur.
Yes.
You maybe tell us why we are here.
Yes.
Gathered.
Yeah. Why are we here?
I'm probably wondering. I can see it in their faces.
Not in the protest sense.
No, nothing.
But like, why are we here and why are you there?
Not in the like a.
Not
in the Heimspiegel, like
the philosopher.
Philosopher. Yes.
No. We have a reason. We are here to tell you about a secret. It's not a well-kept secret. No, but it is one of our nation's sources of pride. And the Icelandic white gold, you might say.
You might call it that.
The milk.
Icelandic milk.
We stand here because we are inspired by the Icelandic milk in all of its many forms.
I believe we speak on the behalf of the entire population of Iceland. When we say that we are truly a children raised by milk, we are the children of the milk. Because it's the first thing we eat when we born, and it's the last thing we drink before we die. And we are here giving this presentation to give you, young, aspiring international artists, a better and a deeper understanding of Icelandic culture, Icelandic agriculture, and of course, my second thing after milk, the Icelandic language, which is also a phenomenon in itself.
But if you beautiful young artists want to understand the link between the milk and the Icelandic nation and its very existence, you have to go way back to the creation of the world in Nordic heathen mythology.
Yes, back in those days, there was nothing except the two worlds of ice and fire, the worlds of Niflheim and Muspell. And when the fires of Muspell and the ice of Niflheim touched, they created the original primal cow called Auðhumla.
Yes, soon after, the giant Ymir was created. He fed on the milk of Auðhumla, which flowed in four mighty rivers from her teats. One day, she was licking the frozen rocks of the primordial world, and out of the rocks came a man's hair.
Yeah, she could see the hair. And the next day she came again, and she licked the rock again, and what appeared then was his head. And like you see in this picture, well, it's not a photograph. But the third day she came again and licked again, and then appeared a whole man. And this man was Búri, who is father of Borg, who is father of Odin, the creator of mankind.
So you're saying like that in a way, we would not be here if it were not for the primal cow.
It is quite obvious that we would not be here if you believe in heathen mythology. that we would not be here without the primal cow with him.
No, but it's not, it's just a story.
It's just, these are not actual facts we are presenting, but more of an idea. But more about the cow, the Icelandic cattle stock is a phenomenon as well in itself. The Icelandic settlers, first Icelandic settlers, brought with them cattle from where they came.
Yes. And after what they brought with them was this cow, this Icelandic cow. It kept them warm and it kept them company because they didn't have central heating in those days. So, but they kept the cow inside their own house. Yes. And that heated the house.
According to genealogy studies, or the Icelandic cow is related, or is, has its roots in Norway, in North Scandinavia. What was the name again?
Tróndarfé.
Yeah, the cattle stock was called Tróndarfé and Norrlandsfé.
Yes, but the Danish, they imported some Danish stocks of cattle in the 19th century, but it seems not to have had a lasting impact on the genetic diversity of the Icelandic stock.
Because of the huge restrictions on agricultural, on import of agricultural products in Iceland, the Icelandic cow produces nearly 100% of all dairy consumed in Iceland every year, which is an amazing statistic if you compare it to other countries.
Despite the risk that comes with centuries of inbreeding, the cow is considered healthy, and it is a marvel and a curiosity to cattle enthusiasts all around the world.
And if we might, for fun, look at some grammar now. We have the four tenses of nouns in Icelandic. And this is the word kýr, which is cow in Icelandic. And if we would put the English word cow into this, it would sound like this. Here is a cow, about a cow, from a cow, to a cow. And in Icelandic it sounds like this. Hér er kýr, kýr, frá kú til kýr.
It's a funny word. But I think Icelanders should maybe take a closer look at it too, and like look it up once in a while. Because we get it wrong too, sometimes.
Yeah, we get it wrong all the time. I think actually we have it wrong on the slide.
You're saying? Well, okay, well some Icelanders foolishly resort to another word, belja. But that is a silly resort and it's kind of derogative.
It's completely derogative and a mean word in itself. But if we continue, the Icelandic milk, which is the produce of the Icelandic cow, is, because of its origins, the purest and best milk in the world. It has the longest recorded history of consistent, uninterrupted production in the world, and is probably the best milk in the world, not because of that fact alone, but because of its links to Auðhumla herself.
And in integral in the Icelandic cuisine is the world famous skyr. It is a thick yogurt-ish substance, rich in protein, and the foundation of Icelandic strength and beauty.
It's like skyr in America. It's very popular in America. It's sold in Whole Foods and other big stores.
Yes, it's just begun to really catch on.
Yeah, so watch out, America. The Icelandic cow is coming for you. it's production. Skyr's production is really... you can link it really closely to Iceland's great success in the Miss World Beauty pageant, where we have three victories now with the most beautiful woman in the world. We have Unnur Birna, we have Hófí Ká, where we have a picture of her here, and Linda Pien, and also to the great success in the World's Strongest Man competition, where we have 8 wins in total. And all of these victories came in the last 30 years, and most of them in the 80s.
Yes. And you know, the creative power that comes with the milk, it has maybe also fueled the creation of our greatest country's greatest artists.
Yes, definitely. Björk.
They have all drunk milk.
Sigurós.
And our Nobel laureate, Haldur Laxness.
Yes. But some may find it easy or cliché just to name these huge pillars of Icelandic culture. But the fact of the matter is that the Icelandic milk has breastfed and inspired young artists throughout the centuries that Iceland continues to produce.
Generations in the past and the present.
The grassroots is hugely influenced by Icelandic milk and Icelandic dairy. Here we have
musicians. Some examples.
Examples. And if we want a closer example, we just have to look at ourselves here.
Don't have to go far. Just outside, there are people who have been drinking milk. Maybe unbeknownst to them.
And what is the first thing we do every morning here at LungA? We wake up and we get breakfast. And what do we eat for breakfast? We eat maybe porridge. We put milk on the porridge. We have maybe yogurt. And we put... That's a dairy product.
Maybe in a coffee.
Yeah. And the coffee and api milk. And then we go and, like, that is the... It's like a key element in creation, in all creativity and in the intelligence, and strength and beauty as well.
Yes, but where does it, you know, come from?
There is the
Icelandic Dairy Syndicate. That is the company that has been feeding us throughout all the years.
Those are the ones that we owe thank you, and we owe everything to the Icelandic Dairy Syndicate. This is Guðni Ágústsson, the former minister of agricultural affairs in Iceland, and now one of the most influential men in the world of dairy, in the whole world, I would say.
It is a fairly young in Icelandic history, founded in 1934, the syndicate by farmers, because the milk farmers united to sell all the milk through one company, one distributor.
There was, however, if I may say, one man. And his name is Thor Jensen, and he was a sociopath and a millionaire.
Correct.
And
which castle called Korpustadir?
Korpustadir, yes.
Outside the dairy syndicate.
It's a horrible story in itself. But together the dairy syndicate, the farmers of the country were strong. They were strong together, and that is how they marginalized him. And put him to his knee.
Parliament passed a law in 1935 that banned farmers from selling outside the dairy syndicate. So since then, the syndicate has been the sole proprietor of dairy in Iceland.
Yes.
So many have tried to produce milk outside it.
Yes, many have tried. Many capitalists have tried to circumvent the dairy syndicate, but most have failed. There is, however, one that we have to mention. That is the company Curies, which is...
It's an ice cream company,
yes.
Founded in 1969 by Hafsteinn Kristinsson, a cheesemaker. But the fact of the matter is, hidden in plain view, that it is not an ice cream company.
No, that is very true, my dear Haukur. And the reason for it's not an ice cream company is that the main ingredient in Curies' ice cream is herbal fat. So there is no actual cream in Curious's ice cream. So it's ironic to say the least.
Yes. But on the other hand, the Icelandic Dairy Syndicate has fought a monumental struggle for preserving our language throughout the years, so since 1994.
Since 1994, when Iceland had a 50th anniversary of independence. Since then, the Dairy Syndicate had a huge impact on Iceland with linguistic awareness and strengthening the vocabulary through advertisements and through printing information about the language, proverbs, nouns and such, on cartons of milk, which the people of Iceland then drink. So they are hugely influential and cannot be ignored. And I think they are this something sometimes is not they are not mentioned enough when we talk about Icelandic culture.
It's a small language that could be lost, like without the Dairy Syndicate.
Yeah.
And now we are maybe we should try and do a little thing in the spirit of the Icelandic Dairy Syndicate.
I like what you're
saying.
We're
going to maybe with you Icelanders here can help. those not speaking Icelandic.
We're going to sing a dairy anthem from 1994.
It's a classic.
It's a classic. And here we have the translation of the lyrics, so you know that you're not singing anything that's
improper
or disrespectful. So if I will read, in Icelandic, you can always find an answer and phrase the big and small that is and was, and she has words that keep our joys and woes of old life and new in city and country. On our lips, the tongue comes alive. That is where our language grows and prospers. To guard her is to keep our nation true. No one will except me and you. So now, we will stand up from our seats and place our hand on our hearts, and we will try to sing this together. And I would like to say that there's a gap between the verses, so do not continue to sing directly. You have to wait for it.
Á íslenskum á allt að finna svar og orða stótt og smá sem er og var og húra sem geyma með og sór gafallt líf og nýtt í sveit og bor
Ná, that's good.
Ég búið að tók ég að bort.
Börum okkar verður tungan þjá Það vex og fræð og dallar okkar má Það gæta hennar gildir mér og nú Það gerir engin nema ég og þú Það gæta hennar gildir mér og nú Það gerir engin nema ég og þú
En þess vinnur markvist að vendu íslenska tungu Deinum stuðningi við notarkastarf og vekur athygli á fjölbreytileika tunguna. Íslenska okkar
mál. On that note, we would like to thank you for...
Thank you for participating in this lecture. This is maybe not the most exciting thing to do on this really exciting festival to see a lecture on milk. But we are grateful for you coming and would like to invite you to have a glass of milk and toast with us. And thank you. For coming.